Ladies and gentlemen, now the moment you've all been waiting for.
You are now listening to the sounds of the Creeps
and Microphones. Cross paths with Nicotina.
Being from San Francisco is kind of like I would say just San Francisco, being kind of from the same neighborhoods too. Like, yeah, we would cross paths. I grew up in Lower Haight, Haight and Fillmore, basically, area. He's from the Mold, you know, right up to over the hill. And he was already Dre Dog, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like back then, Dre Dog, he would definitely come through the neighborhood, sell tapes, sell calendars, sell, you know what I mean? We'd be like, oh shit, bro, that's Dre Dog. He got his shit. So while we were on the block just chilling, doing our thing, you know, he would come by and sell shit. And then while Solidarity Records was coming together, like this is 99, my cousin had his number and they were working on something, which I don't even remember, a movie or something. And then they were like, man, you should do a song with Nicotina, man. That's like you and him are like my favorites right now, bro. That'd be dope if y'all did something. And I was like, I don't know. Like, I didn't really see it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I was more of a like hip hop rapper.
Yeah, you are super hip hop. Yeah,
you know, and it was just like, but you know, at the end of the day, it's like, you know, it was a challenge. You know what I mean? Like, I was like, okay, fuck, let's do a song because we're trying to build my album up, right? Like,
yeah,
this is my first solo album. Okay, we're going to get a feature from him. We'll get a feature, you know, a feature from this dude. And we were planning it out. So, yeah, we ended up just meeting, man, and we planned out to do a song, hit the studio, did the song, Blueprints of War. That was the first song we did. And then it ended up being on a compilation. Like, the song started getting out there. You know what I mean? I think it started like building up traction, yeah, throughout the city and stuff. And then we started just hanging out. Like, he would invite me to, you know, like in stores and certain shows and certain things. And then he put me on his album, the Cocaine Raps album.
Yeah.
The Daiquiri Factory one. We did Al Capone Sweets.
Yep.
And we did that.
That's a hitter. The next level. Hitters right there, man.
And we started performing. You know what I mean? That's when we started doing shows together. I started performing it. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
So we just, you know, it's just kind of built like that, man. It's just, you know, just rap shit, bro. You know, kind of rap shit, city shit. You know, just being each other, having the same acquaintances. We had same friends too. You know what I mean? Like, okay, that's your boy too. You know, it was like, it was just good, you know, a good connection, especially, you know, for that time. You know what I mean? Like, we knocked out fucking 4 albums together.
Yeah,
bro.
It's crazy,
like, that's
bro.
That's pretty incredible. You know what I mean? Like,
that's fucking
people
amazing.
Like, y'all should do another album. I'm like, dude, I don't even appreciate those fucking 4 albums. That shit's not easy.
Yeah, y'all cranked out a lot of tracks.
Yeah, dude, a lot of tracks.
With me, you don't got nobody else. You don't know nobody else that got 4 albums with Nicotina like that. You know what I mean? Like, you just got to let it be the way it is sometimes. Like, you know.
Bro,
so, it was a good time. It's just like that music represents that time. You know what I mean?
Bro.
Like what it was and what was going on.
Some of that album lives rent free in my head forever. Rent free.
Same here.
Paying nothing. That motherfucking album be living in my head. Just you could just hear it.
You guys were that duo for definitely some time period, man. But I like how your roots were always heavily instilled in the hip hop, you know, genre. Mm-hmm. Still, you
always
know?
Always.
Well, bro, like you got a trip too, like. That's why it worked too, because Dre, you can't overlook Dre's hip hop, you know, influence either.
No,
if you listen to his shit, if you really listen to Dre's shit, like Raven in My Eyes,
oh yeah,
Tears, and you hear,
Eli just Eli from Living Legends just put out an album a couple years ago and had Dre on it on one of the tracks on the 808 album.
Yeah.
So he gets down on some hip hop shit too.
Dre's hard, bro. I get that. He's hard.
Nah, I mean, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's what I'm saying. When people say that too, I'd be like, y'all don't really listen to the album. Like, you don't have to talk about flowers and like skipping through the fucking fields and shit, the grass and shit, if you're like to be hip hop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, plenty of people that use the boom bap sound talk about, you know, rambunctious ass gangster shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, especially now, you know what I mean? You got Madlib and Freddie Gibbs and shit like that. But when you listen to the Horns and Halos, you listen to all the first one and all, it's hip hop beats in that shit, bro.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's heavy. Like, that's why I be like, people be saying shit like, y'all ain't even really listening and just talking
storytelling.
Like, you know
too.
What I mean? Like, y'all just taking
oh,
for what it is. Like,
pictures.
Oh, you never seen the gangster rapper with crypto board stiff, the hip hop backpacker. I don't think it's gonna work or whatever. That, you know what I mean? Like,
Y'all
ain't even listening to the fusion of what we created. You know what I mean? Like, but this is part of history, bro. Like, people will get it later. I mean, a lot of people got it, but I think like a lot of people will get it later. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, what it took to make that happen.